music fans, Cathy Rankin here at BLK Live as usual. And you know, we've been having a great time with all the artists and bands that have been coming through here and giving great concerts. But I have to say, this interview that we did with Lita Ford was by far one of my biggest fangirl geek out moments. You can tell I was just giddy in the interview because I was meeting my rock and roll idol. 99% of the time, I'm interviewing men. This time, I got to interview a powerhouse female rocker. And I'll tell you what, Lita did not disappoint. She was awesome, generous, interesting, straightforward, honest, and she was everything you would expect. She told it like it is. So take a look at what we found out. Hey guys, Cathy Rankin here with BrickHouse.tv. And you know, normally I'm pretty professional, but I have to admit, I'm geeking out today because I am sitting with Lita Ford, my musical idol and inspiration on my birthday. So Lita, I definitely want to talk about your Time Capsule album, and I love the songs. But before I get to that, I was thinking on the way over here, you are the queen of metal. People know you. I don't need to introduce what you've done, what you've accomplished. But to me, I was thinking it's so much bigger than just you being a phenomenal guitarist, especially in this day and age. You as a woman broke so many barriers, and I mean really were the first female heavy metal guitarist. And what you've achieved, does it ever hit you the impact and the magnitude of what you've done and how it's paved the way for other women and young girls?
It does now. It didn't at first. You know, I didn't think about it, but I know they're going to start sound check now, so we're going to have rock and roll in the background.
No, that's okay. It's that kind of show.
But it just, I'm glad to be that person. I'm very, very proud of it, and it's something I can carry with me to my grave. Mm-hmm. And be left with a legacy that Lita Ford was one of the first, if not the first heavy metal, hard rock, jamming, non-guitar, you know, icon, legend.
Yeah, it's amazing. So we're watching you in soundcheck, and everybody was just blown away. I mean, we have fans waiting in the parking lot, and you sound incredible. Vocally, you sound incredible. Your guitar playing is always phenomenal. And you're such a front woman. When you started out in music, did you have to develop that to be out and actually front a band? I mean, you knew you could play guitar, but...
I did, actually. I did have to develop it because at first, guitar for me was a gift from God. You know, I just picked it up at 11 years old and, Jimi Hendrix? Yeah, I can play that. It was ridiculous. So I started jamming on all my favorite records. But then after the Runaways broke up, I became a solo artist, and that was a whole different animal. I had to learn to sing. Because nobody I had auditioned could do what I wanted them to do. And then it comes in that old saying where if you want something done right, do it yourself.
Do yourself, yeah.
So I rented a warehouse in Long Beach, California, where my parents lived. And I taught myself to sing, play, and entertain all at the same time. How do you play guitar, sing a lead vocal, and entertain thousands of people at the same time? So the first trick for me was don't look at your guitar neck, because everybody I watched was hiding behind their hair.
Yeah.
They were always, you get this.
And you didn't have women to look at. You had to look at the front men.
That's right. There were no front women to idolize.
Right, that played guitar like you did and were doing the rest as
well. There were other women that played guitar.
Right.
But they weren't hard rock and they weren't as young as I was.
Right.
Being in the Runaways, we were only 16 when we started. We weren't even women yet.
Yeah.
So that's one up on a lot of people that already did play guitar. And then there's people like Bonnie Raitt who played the blues.
Yeah, I loved her.
And Slide, and just different styles of playing. So I got my icon award for playing hard rock and heavy metal.
And that's exactly the way we like it. Now tell me about, so Time Capsule is such an interesting album, and you released it last year. and you found these analog tapes that you had, music you had never released, and there's so many guest artists on it. I've listened to the whole album. The songs are incredible. So how did you...
Thank you.
Love Mr. Corruption is one of my favorite songs. Of course,
it's
the girls.
Such a great
song. Go listen to it, girls. You can relate.
Yeah.
But what was the process like in taking the analog tapes and being able to convert everything and make it sound the way you wanted?
Well, it was scary at first because they were older and you have to bake them. So in order to bake them, you have to put them in some sub-temperature, like it's ridiculously hot. And I'm thinking, they're going to melt. I'm going to have nothing left. And that didn't work. Because otherwise, if you don't bake them, you put them on the reel and they fall apart. They flake apart. So you have to bake them before you convert them over to digital. And we did. We baked them. It was a success. And everything came out fine. We transferred it over to digital, no problem. So now I have two versions of the album. One digital, one analog.
Thank goodness it worked, though. I mean, was there like a moment where you were, you know, a little stressed about what might happen, what could happen? Because then they would be lost forever.
Big time. I was freaking out because there's so many great players on these tapes. And these tapes were done at a time where I had the studio. I was a producer. I got to do everything I wanted to do myself. Mm-hmm. And people that were on the album were just passerbyers.
Yeah.
Like Dave Navarro was in the studio next door. Dave, you play some mandolin? Sure. So he'd come over and he'd put down some mandolin. You got Dave Navarro. Gene Simmons. Gene had a song that he had already started with Bruce Kulick called Rotten to the Core. He played bass on it. Bruce Kulick played some guitar. We had Rick and Robin from Cheap Trick singing backing vocals.
It's crazy. It's very organic. It's very organic music, how it happened. So now you've got that out and you're touring. And how does it feel at this stage of your career to be touring and seeing the reception you're getting?
It's incredible. It's a whole nother chapter to my life that I never thought would ever happen. You know, I ended it to have my sons, and they got to be a little bit older, and I was able to play rock and roll and not have to worry about an infant in the back of the bus.
Right.
Don't smoke back there!
Right.
It wasn't like that. I stayed with my kids until they were old enough to handle themselves, and just entering and coming back into the music world was not like riding a bike. It was something I had to relearn.
That's interesting.
You know, people would think, you got this. It's like riding a bike. No, it isn't at all. Because it's, like I said, it's entertaining thousands of people. It's playing guitar. It's playing singing and looking good and keeping your weight down and having that confidence to get on stage and go, all right, Arizona, what's going down tonight?
So you have to get back in the mindset.
Yes.
To get back in the mindset. What do you do to take care of yourself now? Because you look fantastic. You sound fantastic.
Thank you.
I mean, that's an accomplishment in and of itself, just to be... the energy it takes to be on stage is crazy. How do you do that, you know, after having been out of it for so long?
Even Mickey said to me, he goes, girl, what are you doing? He goes, this is insane. He turned around and looked at Bobby, you know, Bobby runs 10 miles a day. He's all ripped. The guys are in great shape. Nobody does drugs. Nobody smokes. Nobody drinks. And we just work out.
So you just take care of yourself.
Yeah, we do healthy things.
So, last question. You had your book out. You had your book out, and I found your book. You're so candid and straightforward. You're just a straight shooter. You've been through it all.
Yeah.
You know, the ups and the downs. Do you have any regrets? Do you have any regrets? Or do you look at all of it as, you know, just these are all pieces and parts of my journey?
They're pieces and parts of my journey. And not everybody loves what I said, because I do bash a few people. And But that was only because they bashed me.
Right.
And, you know, there were certain things that I think are romantic, and people say, oh, it's sex. Well, there was a lot of drugs, sex, drugs, and rock and roll in the 80s. You know, I'd be stupid to say, no, there isn't.
Right.
Of course there was. You're damn right there was. But a lot of it was romantic, mm-hmm. and it depends on how you look at it, how you read it. Some of it is so funny, you find yourself crying
yeah.
with humor. So there's a lot going on in that book. And
but
I'm
that's
very
what I,
proud.
Yeah, and you should be, and that's what I like about it. I don't like when you read a book and somebody leaves out parts that aren't
right.
convenient, or
right.
you don't feel like you're getting the true person. And that's what I like about yours.
When you start to write a book, you really start to get into it. And then some people go, oh, no, I can't talk about that.
Right. So
my
you
mother,
censor yourself.
What's my father going to say? So that's what happens with when you start to write a book. But I didn't do that. I just plowed on through.
That's awesome.
Said, I don't care. I don't want to hear it. You know, this is real, this is not. So I just gave the audience what they wanted to hear, the truth.
Yeah, and I think...
Like it or not.
Well, and I think that's pretty much how you've lived your whole career.
Yeah.
You know, and I
yeah.
think people would expect that, and I think it's nice that that's... You stayed true to yourself, so...
Right.
So, well,
yeah.
we're excited about the show tonight. We
Thank you.
Really appreciate you sitting down with us.
Thanks
and
so much.
These are her adorable... You can't see the other dog, but she's got two little pups. Hear her little babies. And are they going to be at the show tonight as well? Come on, baby.
What is it with you?
Are they going to be here for the whole show?
No, there's too many people.
They go home.
No resting room.
They go home. Well, are you going to have fun tonight? Because you're going to have a big crowd.
Oh, yeah.
So
we're going to tear this place up.
We're going to tear it up. And it's my birthday. And this is like the
yes.
best way I could spend it with the queen of metal, you
Thank
guys.
You.
So
Thank you.
Thanks for joining us. And we'll have fun tonight. We'll see you guys at the next show.
And happy birthday.
Thank you. I'm so excited. Okay, guys, so maybe I embarrassed myself just a little, but Lita played along and humored me. And what more could I ask for than to see her personal concert right in front of me on my birthday? It was a fantastic time. And by the way, she gave a performance that blew people away. She came out, what I loved about her, she came out on stage looking and acting every bit the rock star that she is. And she has the chops on guitar and vocals to back it up. That's why we love Lita Ford, and that's why she's the queen of metal. We'll see you guys again at the next show.